What's up, my peoples? Welcome back to another episode of Matinee Rewind. It is your boy here, Manny, and today I want to talk to you about the latest release from Pusha T. It's Almost Dry. Well, is it? For those of you who are not familiar with Pusha T, let me break it down for you real quick. All right, so Pusha T is an American rapper and a record exec who rose to his prominence as the better half of the hip-hop duo The Clips, along with his brother No Malice. Now, together those two dropped 3 studio albums and tons of mixtapes, but it was the hit single Grinding that got these guys popular. Throughout the years, Pusha T has made many good alliances in the game. For example, in 2010, he signed to Kanye West's Good Music imprint, which was under Def Jam Recordings. And then in that same year, he actually was featured on Kanye West's album and was on the song Runaway, which actually was a pretty big hit. In 2011 is when Pusha T got the opportunity to drop his first album. This was his debut solo album. It's called My Name Is My Name. All right, so then it came out in 2013. But anyways, in 2015, Kanye West appointed Pusha T to take over his role as the president of Good Music. And ever since then, Pusha T has been the main man in charge. Along with dropping 3 more solo albums, King Push, Darkest Before Dawn, The Prelude in 2015, which I'm a huge fan of, Daytona, which was the one where we went back and forth with some beef with Drake, and then the recent one, It's Almost Dry. Now, this dude, he was born in New York City, but he grew up in Virginia Beach, Virginia. One of his earliest setups with The Clips was his relationship that he built with the Neptunes, and specifically Pharrell Williams. Actually, Pharrell Williams is the one that gave him the name Pusha T. Now, it was that relationship that helped launch him into a different stratosphere. You see, with production from guys like Kanye West and Pharrell Williams, come on, man. There's no way you can't hit a home run with those dudes producing records for you. Another thing is that Pusha T is one of the only artists, there's not too many of them, that could call up Hove, Jay-Z himself, and say, I need you to be featured on my new album. I need a verse from you. There's not a lot of people in the industry that can call up Jay and get a verse from him. He's still got a big, you know, presence in this game. I mean, he made appearances on some huge, huge albums over the years. But anyways, what we're here to discuss today is his newest album called It's Almost Dry. All right, so this album has guest features from Kanye West, Jay-Z, Pharrell Williams, Lil Uzi Vert, Kid Cudi, Don Toliver, and also go check out, if you don't know who Nego is, I got a video down in the link in the description. It's called Who Is Nego? Explains all about this dude. Interesting video. Go check it out. It's Almost Dry. I believe that's a reference to the hip-hop game kind of running out of quality music being put out. Now, most artists want to claim that they're the only one that's putting out good music. And this clearly is a metaphor for the drug game, the coke game running dry, as well as the hip-hop game in a parallel running dry of its supply of good product. And that makes a lot of sense because he did a guest appearance on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon, and then he held an album listening party in New York that he named Coachella. The album release was preceded by its first single, which was called Diet Coke. So this was a whole entire marketing strategy that they were going to use as this idea. The second single was Hear Me Clearly, which is a song featuring Nego. Then you have the song Neck and Wrist, which features appearances from Jay-Z and Pharrell Williams. This one was released not too long ago. All right, so throughout this Pusha T album, I'm not going to go through and break down every single song, but I just want to give you a kind of a vibe of what the album sounds like so you know what you're going into. If you haven't listened to it, you should definitely give this album a check out. I'll give it 2 thumbs up. I think that this type of hip hop is exactly what I need in my life at this moment, so I was really happy to hear it. Aside from maybe 2 songs on it, one of them being Let the Smokers Shine the Coops, I just don't really like the beat and the vibe of the song. But this is a really, it's sort of like a love letter to hip hop, because not by him going along in his lyrics and, you know, saying how much he loves hip hop or anything like that. No. Pusha T doesn't do that. If you don't know, Pusha T he's the head of the table. He doesn't speak like he's, you know, anything else. All right. His cocaine talk does get a little bit boring, but anyways, these dudes love to use that as metaphors for an idea or for a way of living. This is this culture. This is how it is. Along the way, you get a different flavor of multiple eras of hip hop on this album. There are some songs that are heavily sampled, like the Kanye West one, Dreaming of the Past. It's a sample that everybody's been waiting to hear Kanye go back to that style of doing music. Along with that, you have Just So You Remember, which is a slowed down, serious. It just speaks in a different way. You have Rock and Roll, which we got some humming from Kid Cudi, and they consider that a feature. I guess there was some problems again between Kid Cudi and Kanye West, but he allowed Pusha T to put this out. Then you have Scrape It Off, which is a song with Don Toliver and Lil Uzi Vert. These are 2 modern day rappers who have a different sound that Pusha T had to lend himself to something a little bit different. The song is actually pretty good. It isn't like a skippable song. It featured from Nego. And then also on the very last song, he has a feature from his brother, who used to be called No Malice. Now his name is Malice. Pusha T makes good quality hip hop. He's not my favorite rapper, and as a rapper, he can get boring. So whoever executive produced this album made sure that you don't get bored of Pusha T because of the high quality beats on here. You kind of get dragged along and you never want to turn it off. So that's a thumbs up for Pusha T. If you have the time, go and check it out. Make sure you like and subscribe and leave a comment on your thoughts on the Pusha T album, because I'd love to hear what everybody else is thinking about it. So yeah, we out. Peace.